Thursday.
You can't. Thursdays is Thursday. Sundays is day.
I can't do Thursday no more anyway because mom changed back to evening. She goes work at 2 o'clock.
2 p.m. Yeah.
We got that going. Is that already started?
If you want to, your cops, if y'all want a good lead, just go to them Jew communities. You're going to find the main actors in baby porn blowjob. You know, fetus poke blowjob porn.
Oh, man.
Those are the main actors, those Jews.
I don't have my apocrypha. I forgot it. That was reading. Damn. I forgot I had it out of reading. I got it on my phone. You guys got a phone. Yeah, get that sign. Oh shit, they wanna get a lead on them terrorist attacks over there in France. I wonder who was behind that.
CIA.
Yeah.
That's a sign of funny how they said the CIA was.
And Mossad. The CIA, Mossad, and France's intelligence agency all had a meeting a week ago.
Our CIA is.
The day before the attacks.
Oh, well, right before it happened, yeah.
The day before.
And another thing, too, the band that was playing, what was the name of the band?
Oh, the heavy metal band.
It was called, Eagles of Death?
Woo! Wow. And that ain't
the question. And the name of the singer or something, his name, he called himself the Devil. And the show that they played right before there was in Israel. So that was all part, it's all symbolism.
Mm-hmm. Ain't no coincidence.
And those Paris attacks happened on Friday the 13th, which goes back to the Friday the 13th when hundreds of years ago, when King Philip IV of France, he executed a bunch of Knight Templars for worshiping the devil. And King Philip IV of France was also famous for expelling those fake Jews out of France. He kicked them out. He's like, you motherfuckers gotta go. Kick their asses out.
That's crazy, man.
So it's all that symbolism. Yeah, I mean, we can see it.
It's beautiful.
That is really beautiful, yeah, because like we care about a bunch of French faggots. We don't care about them. We're happy that happened.
Seen Daryl posted today, I've never been to France.
I don't want to go to France. Actually, the Muslims already conquered that shit. Because the so-called Jew, the Muslims is their main puppet that they use and control. The United States government is the one who's supplying them with all those weapons.
Yeah, it sure is, yeah. Yeah, they're going to get fed. There's a reason why how these nations are going to turn against America, man.
Right, because if ISIS was so anti-Semitic as they claim, how come ISIS haven't attacked Israel? You think that'd be the first spot they would attack, right? If they so anti-Semitic, why can they even attack Israel? Because that shit was created by Israel.
They gonna get them.
It don't take a rocket scientist to figure this shit out. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But these people, they so dumb. I like what he's talking about, those Paris attacks. Isn't it funny how all these slogans and everything, they roll them out like it's on cue. You get on YouTube, they got the YouTube channel is a flag of a Paris flag, and it says we stand with Paris. And do you see that little peace symbol they keep passing around? It looks like the Eiffel Tower, but it's a peace symbol.
Mm-mm.
You see that, right? But it's like they already had that design before the attacks happened, and they just rolling everything out on cue. You know what I mean? It's like they had artwork pre-planned because this attack was pre-planned by the elite. Man, we ain't stupid.
I asked somebody what they think about it yesterday. They ain't know nothing about the Paris attacks, man. These people are
I bet they don't know about Ronda Rousey getting her ass beat, though.
Yeah, that bitch got knocked the fuck out.
They know about that. Oh, yeah, see, damn. Yeah, that bitch did get her ass beat. If that's even real. If that's even real at all. Cause just think, whoever bet against her, cause
she got kicked in the head and barely got kicked in the head.
Cause who in their right mind would bet against her, right? So if you bet against Ronda Rousey, you made a killing. Yeah. You made a serious come up.
Because they market the hell out of that bitch.
Yeah.
Then they gamble.
That's like clockwork, man. So, yeah, you had a feeling that her big fall was coming, so somebody can make a lot of money.
My instructor quit buying the UFCs because...
He said it was fake?
No, because Ronda Rousey was winning every match. Like, that's all people care about.
Because it was already known that the bitch couldn't box.
They set her up for that,
They sure did.
They set her up.
They gave her the right opponent because that bitch she fought was a fighter. You can see there's videos of her boxing with John Jones.
It's
all with the motherfucker.
Then they say the bitch she was fighting was a transsexual.
Yeah. Huh?
Then they say the bitch she was fighting was transgender. No,
I didn't even see it. I don't even watch that bullshit, man. I watch some real sport. Boxing's a real sport. UFC's not a sport. UFC's fucking... That's just barbarism. That's not a sport. That's just whoop motherfuckers' ass anyway by any means necessary. Submission
Holds? Yeah. Yeah. Break a motherfucker's neck.
Yeah, that's why for the longest time it was always the jiu-jitsu guys that was winning. Now everybody training jiu-jitsu. I don't watch that. I watch
Boxing. Oh, Royce Gracie about to make a comeback to fight Ken Shamrock.
Man, he's old as hell. Oh, they both old as hell. Ken Shamrock's a killer.
Yeah, he's a good Ken Shamrock.
Now, he's a real... He's a bad dude, you know what I mean?
Kimbo whipped his ass, man.
Yeah, he did. But he got a lot of respect from the other fighters. Kimbo Slice, he threw all kind of fights.
Yeah,
you see some of those losses?
He be throwing up the symbol, though.
Yeah, he sold out. A lot of those fights he lost, he threw those fights. At least y'all wearing dresses.
Hey, come on, what's up? Ask me a question. Ask me a quick question.
Sorry.
That's good.
Have a good day. All right. What'd she say? Nah, man, we ain't worried about no women anywhere. But at least you can still see their ass and everything. Got a slit going right up the dress, so they still lose. You giving no props to no hoes out here. We don't love them hoes.
Snoop said it in 94.
That's a picture about that pair.
Yeah, bring that out.
Stone's 10.
Who's from?
10 to 7. His tongue is full of cursing.
Read that again. Okay.
Stone's 10 to 7. His mouth is full of cursing and deceit and fraud. Under his tongue is mischief and vanity.
You see the look on her face?
Yeah, when she was over there, she was like, what the fuck is going on here?
Yeah, she was looking at the sign. She was bugging out.
Yeah, she really saw this one and just, oh my God.
She looked like a so-called Jew. Hey.
I like that.
She looked like somebody I like to ravish.
You start talking to bitches like you're Beavis and Butthead. Like, what's up, baby?
Look at these people like, and wonder, like, wow, man. The internet and plus the brothers on the streets been out here for countless how long. And they still like stuck on stupid when they see it, man. Like it don't exist. Like it's not supposed to exist. This is crazy, man.
It's
fucking crazy.
They way past gone.
It's amazing.
It is amazing. I just praise the Lord every time I see it, actually.
Because
You know, that proves that God exists is because the only way that people could be this goddamn stupid is that there has to be a God. That's the only explanation. Just the only explanation.
Your camel toe is showing.
Yeah, yoga pants aren't pants. They're not supposed to be meant to be wearing that pants.
Go ahead, bring that scripture out.
Psalms 10, 7. His mouth was full of cursing and deceit and fraud. Under his tongue is mischief and vanity.
Mischief and vanity ain't nothing but a lying devil that's always plotting to do some evil, wicked shit.
Yeah, just like the president of the United States, he'll get up there, he'll give you a big old line of bullshit talking about we staying with Paris. When he had a hand in that whole Paris deal, you know what I mean?
Right. Talking about those taxes on all of us.
That's why they keep shipping more and more Muslims in here, because soon that's going to come here. And they go, because like I said, the so-called Jew, their main puppet is the Muslim. They use those Muslims, because them Arabs, they're some of the dumbest people on the planet. Yeah, I mean, you get them to do anything you want, huh?
themselves up.
Yeah, they'll blow themselves up, you know, for the CIA.
It's the spirit of the wild man.
Because a lot of those top ISIS leaders are actually CIA or Mossad operatives, you know what I mean? Man, these people don't know nothing, though, man.
Oh, shit. As they ought to be.
Because they had Senate hearings. When you got people being questioned, like, why is this country supplying ISIS with weapons? I mean, that's on C-SPAN. You can watch it on C-SPAN. But you know, we don't know nothing, so.
Right.
Oh, even Donald Trump was saying it. You see that speech Donald Trump just gave up in Iowa? He said, Donald Trump came out and said, there's many people to say that the United States is arming ISIS. Even he said it.
Hell, America says it. The government says it anyway.
Yeah, the government says it. They tell you.
You know, what's John McCain's dumbass?
They got pictures of John McCain that he posed with an ISIS soldier who was also filmed eating a human heart.
Smiling and shit.
Smiling with him. Like,
that's my boy.
And John McCain said that he was a moderate Muslim. Eating a human heart is moderate.
Right. Well, we know the Quran ain't worth shit if it teaches cannibalism.
Yeah. Yeah, really, exactly.
Can't go to the Quran for a lawful book. Man.
Well, that Quran's some bullshit anyway.
And them motherfuckers trying to push up evangelists butt naked like a motherfucker on Press TV. Y'all know who butt naked is? Evangelist over here in the west coast of Africa. Over in Ghana and I can't say, what is that? I can't remember what it is. Well, anyway, those motherfucking Israelites over there having war just like the Bloods and Crips here.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
But they killing each other, but they'll drink each other's blood and shit.
And they'll eat, no, they'll eat their victim.
Yep,
They'll eat the flesh of their enemy.
Yep, and General Butt Naked, who's now an evangelist over there, he's... So, I mean, you listen to his speeches, man, this motherfucker's awesome.
His name's really Butt Naked?
That's what they call him, General Butt Naked. he's a popular preacher over there, man. And you listen to his teeth, you don't know what the fuck he's talking about, man.
He speaks English?
Yeah, it's perfect English. That's all they speak over there.
I might have to look that one up.
Yeah.
That one's slip.
Just watch Press TV. It's been on Press TV all day, the last few days, man.
Yeah, I never watched Press TV. Yeah, I need Press to. TV. I gotta start watching that shit again.
General Butt Naked, man.
Yeah, because Press TV, that's that shit that Tarpley was always on. What's his name?
Roy.
That Tarpley motherfucker. Webster Tarpley?
Webster. Well,
what, you know, okay. I got tired of listening to his ass.
Yo, fuck
him. He comes out of them Leonard LaRouche motherfuckers.
Yeah, Press TV bad because they do have nice documentaries,
yeah,
though. They're playing documentaries once a week or something.
Yeah, I used to follow him. I forgot all about him.
Yeah.
I be watching RT and I watch a lot of shit.
You had more of that? Yes, that was it on that. Okay, let me read this real quick. This is Obadiah 1:6. How are the things of Esau searched out? How are his hidden things sought out?
Yeah, Esau, the chief house of Esau is the house of Amalek, the so-called Jew. And that's what we've been searching this bullshit out, exposing this lie. That's what that's talking about. Now everybody's aware of who's behind all these attacks.
Yeah.
Well, not everybody, but...
Yeah.
Man, you get up. As soon as those Paris attacks happened, YouTube was flooded with all kind of videos because people was paying attention to what's going on, and they breaking down each little news article, news video. People was breaking shit down on every video, showing you all the discrepancies in the official story.
Mm.
You know what I mean?
Mm.
I mean, they on that shit like a hobo on a ham sandwich.
That was beautiful, man. Especially the video with playing soccer and the bombs, you can hear the bombs going off.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, that was nice, man.
That's beautiful.
How many people died? 130?
That's at 150, past 150?
It's up there. It's up high.
Yeah.
That's cool.
That is cool. I mean, we pray it happens soon. Even more.
Yep, soon it's going to come here. Soon. All the men of thy confederacy have brought thee even to the border. The men that were at peace with thee have deceived thee and prevailed against thee, and they that eat thy bread have laid a wound under thee. There is none understanding in him. Shall I not in that day, said the Lord, even destroy the wise men out of Edom and the understanding out of the mount of Esau? And they, mighty men, O Teman, shall be dismayed, to the end that every one of the mount of Esau may be cut off by slaughter.
Yeah, we're going to slaughter them. The Lord's going to use us to slaughter them. It's going to be a great slaughter, too. You know what I'm saying?
A lot of ravaging going on.
A lot of all them Edomite women, they're going to get ravaged.
Yeah, they be thick, too, don't they?
They be, hey.
Thick.
We're going to do what needs to be done.
Nope.
Ain't going to be no mercy. What they say, there going to be no quarter. There's going to be no quarter on that day.
It's coming quickly now. Bro.
It is coming quickly.
Whew. Damn, 2016 is right there.
It's like this last year didn't even happen.
I'm here. Damn, man. Good Lord Almighty.
And that's the second time Paris got fucked up, too, what, in the past year? They deserved it, too.
Within the last 6 months.
Yep. With that Charlie Hebdo shit, that wasn't too long ago, was
it? That's right. France. A lot of shit popping off over there. That's the main top tourist spot for Esau, too.
Not no more, it ain't. Ha!
Them motherfuckers was living, dude, they was living it up, too, man.
Well, half of Paris is goddamn Muslim now, anyway.
Motherfucking grown-ass men was running like women over there, man. They was running like women. Didn't even man up and be like, we gotta do something. Motherfucker was running like women, man. They was passing the women up.
Nope. Every man for himself.
Yeah.
That's beautiful, though. That's beautiful, man.
Well, you know, they want to be men.
We just wish it would happen here, man. I'm just pissed off it didn't happen here.
I know.
But you know, like I said, we gotta be patient.
I know.
We gotta be patient. We can't get mad. You know, man. We gotta just be happy something happened.
We're them fireworks that's waiting for the grand finale.
Yeah. Cause you know the Lord gonna give us something even better than that. That's
way better.
That's like chump change. Yeah, and we wait for something better than that. Cause really, that's really weak. That's really not even that big of a deal.
Yeah, that's true.
Cause we got 9/11, so that's way better actually.
Yeah.
You know, 3,000 motherfuckers died.
2 buildings on top of 3 buildings on top of the end.
Yeah, so that was beautiful that happened.
Shit, how many died in Oklahoma?
A few hundred.
Oh, yeah, Oklahoma. You talking
children
about,
and everything.
Oklahoma, oh, what? Texas.
Timothy McVeigh.
Yeah, Oklahoma City bombing. Timothy McVeigh. Yeah. That was the government behind that one, too.
Yeah.
Because that was all anti-militia propaganda. So they can get the militia men was behind it. Now, if you're in the militia, that means you're evil. So they set that Timothy McVeigh dude up, killed his ass. You know, all these major attacks, hey, I got it right, the sign right here. U.S. government or terrorists. They're behind every fucking major terrorist attack. Every fucking one of them. Go ahead.
Psalms 32:9. Be not as the horse or as the mule, which have no understanding, whose mouth must be held in with bit and bridle, lest they come near unto thee.
That's pretty much saying, yeah, horses. I mean, you can take it to cattle too. Like these people, they don't know nothing. The only thing they know is what they've been spoon-fed by the government or by the government-ran media. By what they seen on TV.
Media.
Huh?
The so-called Jew-ran media.
Yeah, the Jews, they control all this shit. They control Hollywood, all the music they listen to. And these people don't even dig deep to find the good underground music. They just take whatever comes out the industry, you know?
The garbage.
Cause I be digging deep to find some real shit. Not these fools. They be on Vivo. Listen to that bullshit on Vivo. You know, they're just zombies. You know what I mean?
I was so surprised, man. What's it called? France was attacking Syria. And I was like, what about Russia, though? Because Russia's been doing that shit in Syria. Nobody giving Russia credit for bombing shit.
Yeah, but France is going to attack Assad, though. They're not attacking ISIS.
Man, check it out. During those attacks, they found a so-called passport. Here go the passport shit again.
Yeah, every time there's an attack, they find the passport.
Here comes the passport shit again.
Just like
the same old bullshit.
God,
man.
It's the same shit.
Same shit. They can't deviate from the script.
It's like you just laugh at it now.
The
you don't
same
know.
Shit.
Then they have to use the same skinny bitch.
Oh, the same crisis.
They do this shit on purpose to make us look stupid.
Mm-hmm. Right, just
they
like
they laughing
I'm not...
at us because we're like trying to point them out and no one cares.
Right.
They're behind the scenes going, ha ha.
It's like that 9/11 shit. On 9/11, they said two planes blew up. Two buildings pulverized. Ain't nothing. Toilets. Ain't a toilet left. A filing cabinet left. Everything's pulverized, but they find a goddamn passport.
They found a whole bunch of them.
Never in history has a black box ever came up missing, and four of them came up missing on one day.
Oh, yeah, there you go. The black box is indestructible.
Dumbass mobile bikes. That's some funny shit. That's some funny shit, man. The passport shit. Perfectly intact.
Yeah, man. They found a passport at the Charlie Hebdo shooting. So you gonna tell me terrorists just run around with passports
on? All the information.
With all the information.
That's like a nigga in the hood.
He had a map in his pocket that had an X on it said, hideout. You know what I'm saying?
Maybe they are that goddamn dumb.
And it could be, man. I don't know.
You know what I'm saying? I'm not surprised.
Yeah, on 9/11, though, what happened, well, this is what happened. The dude was flying the plane. And then he rolled down in the window, because you know on planes you can roll the window down like on a car. And he rolled the window down. It was a manual. It didn't want electric. It was a roller. You rolled it down.
Right,
and then
right.
Right before he hit, he tossed that motherfucker out the window. He's like, they going to know. They going to know it was me.
Just right. I'm going to be popular. Fucking dumbass shit.
So that's why, yeah.
And he happened to be from Syria. Why?
Syria, of all places.
Out of all places.
Syria. Mm. Matt, how convenient. That's just happens to be where the United States is wants to take over next. Oh, just like General Wesley Clark said.
Hey,
remember,
Esau.
You remember General Wesley Clark was about 6-7 years ago? He said, because after he retired from the Army, he used to be one of the top generals in the Army, right? But General Wesley Clark said that he was told the United States and NATO and everything, they was going to go away in the Middle East, and first they was going to take out Iraq. They said it was like a 10-year plan. They said it was a so many year plan. I forgot how many years they were supposed to accomplish it.
Right, right.
But first they were supposed to take out Iraq. Then they was going to take out Libya and Egypt. And the last one country on the table was Iran. They said they was going to take out Syria. And just like clockwork, they went over there and they taken out all these countries. Because what they want to do is they want to encircle Iran. Because that's what they really want is Iran. Because Iran is like the last free country over there. That's not under NATO control. They want to control that shit. So they can fully establish that new world order. That one world government. It's almost there. But you ain't gonna get Iran.
Hell.
You ain't getting Iran.
Plus, Iran got business, $1 billion business with China and Russia.
Yep.
So it ain't gonna allow that shit. America just going. They going in there.
Persian.
They going to go in there.
That's some proud shit.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, proud.
That's proud. You think you gonna take down Persia?
Mm-mm.
You proud.
Mm-mm.
You out your goddamn mind. It ain't happening.
I can't wait to see some of it, though.
I can't wait to see it.
You know we at the end then.
Yeah, because Iran is not no little fucking hole-in-the-wall country.
Yeah, they ain't Iran.
That's a fucking civilization. That's a motherfucking...
a military might.
Yeah, military might.
You know?
Just like Russia.
Yep. That's a military might. No motherfuckers can call on millions of them.
Oh, and you seen Russia just tested another ICBM out of their submarines. Was that two days ago. It looked beautiful. You said they had it on camera and everything. It was beautiful.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Some new advanced type missiles.
So why do they keep testing all these missiles? And America's been testing missiles, too. They said they seen even more missiles being shot off over there in California.
More arrows.
Unsuccessful.
But they do call them arrows in the Bible, too.
We're going to talk ancient for now.
Well, even the Bible said that the Lord shoots arrows. I can get a scripture to prove that.
Okay.
To prove it as a metaphor.
That's right.
Oh, where did I read that? It's in Psalms. Let me find it.
Arrows.
But the Lord gonna shoot some arrows on your asses too.
That's right, the man of war. The Lord is a man of war.
Yes, of course.
The Lord is a man of war. The Lord is his name. He likes arrows. He got advanced arrows.
Oh, you want to hear about them advanced arrows? Let me get it.
Advanced.
Psalms 18. I'm going to start at 6. Psalms 18 and 6. In my distress, I called upon the Lord and cried unto my God. He heard my voice out of his temple, and my cry came before him, even into his ears. Then the earth shook and trembled. The foundations also of the hills moved and were shaken because he was wroth. Then went up a smoke out of his nostrils, and a fire out of his mouth devoured. Coals were kindled by it. He bowed the heavens also and came down, and darkness was under his feet. So when I say the Lord came down out the heavens, talking about them chariots, those spaceships. Well, that, you know, that's a chariot. You say spaceship, it ain't like nothing out of Star Wars. This is some shit you ain't never seen before.
Ain't the Enterprise.
No, this ain't the Enterprise. No. The starship, yeah. And he rode upon a cherub and did fly. Yeah, he did fly upon the wings of the wind. He made darkness his secret place. His pavilion round about him were dark waters and thick clouds of the skies. At the brightness that was before him was thick clouds past hailstones of coals and fire. That's the hellfire, those the fire and brimstone. You know, people, you preachers talking about fire and brimstone, they think that's talking about hell. No, that's talking about the Lord blasting your ass with some laser beams and fire.
Yeah, they have no understanding.
They have no understanding.
No understanding. No imagination in the scriptures, man.
Nope.
They can't. When we read the scriptures, we can visualize.
We can visualize it.
You know, in our minds, a hologram is going on. But these preachers, man,
they gone.
Yeah.
Let me read this again. The Lord also thundered in the heavens. Actually, did I skip it? No, that's right. Psalms 18 and 13. The Lord also thundered in the heavens. That means up in the sky, outer space, all of that. The Lord also thundered in the heavens, and the highest gave his voice, hailstones and coals of fire. Yea, he sent out his arrows and scattered them, and he shot out lightnings and discomfited them.
ICBM missiles.
So you're going to tell me the Lord's actually up there with arrows. That's a metaphor.
Like Zeus with arrows.
Like some Indians.
Because so, the word arrow. Arrows. Yeah, the word arrow is just like the word missile. Okay. Back in the ancient world, back in the old English or middle English, whatever, they called arrows missiles back then. So it's just a projectile.
I don't think the Most High is using some ancient technology. I think he got more advanced technology than everyone.
Man, he got some technology that surpasses technology.
He created the technology.
That shit goes beyond technology.
You can't even put in words.
You can't.
You know? You can't. You know?
That's
a sin to even go there.
Yeah, it is.
Because you'll find yourself lying and
bugged out.
Make it up, yeah.
Think they figured out the mind of the Most High.
Right. Who was that who got stoned, that was died and came back? They saw the
vision. Was Stephen.
That was Stephen. Yeah. Right. He saw visions of it and came back and couldn't even speak on it, man.
In Acts the 7th chapter.
Wait a minute, Acts 7?
I can get it.
Because I think, okay, that's cool. I think he even said that it's unlawful for him to even speak
on those things.
There you go. That's right, bro.
Oh, no, I think, was that him that said it, or was that Paul that said it?
Paul went to the second heaven. Because they both got slaughtered.
I think that was Paul when the Lord showed him and he said it was unlawful to speak
Let me look it up.
That was Paul.
Let me look it up.
Because it was Stephen who said he seen the Son of the Most High sitting next to him. They're all my favorite. It was all one flesh. One.
Yeah. Hey, when the Spirit get on you, man, you're oblivious to pain, man. It's
you don't even care.
You know? Right.
You get bold, you know what I'm saying? You go crazy. You don't give a fuck. You wish a motherfucker would. You know. You feel like you feel like you getting that spirit. Yeah. You feel like, oh man, my phone died. Piece of shit. I charged that bitch. That shit. I've had that phone for like 5 years. I don't know if I can search it on this one. Just do a word search on heaven and look for Corinthians. I think it's in one of the Corinthians. Oh, I got a concordance in my Bible. The walking concordance on the where it's at. I just read that not too long ago.
I don't feel sorry though.
You can't remember all this stuff,
right? Right. You know, it's just a humbling experience. You know, it just makes you stay humble, and I can't get over, you know, all hot headed and shit. Like I'm the shit. You know, nothing wrong with that.
I be forgetting. I have scriptures memorized forever, then I forget them.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Simple stuff too.
Yeah, like this one. Oh, this ain't a concordance. This is freaking Bible dictionary. They give you them fake breakdowns they got in the Bibles. Oh, here it is. So the Lord ain't playing, man. And the shit's about to hit the fan. I can't wait. The shit's going to hit the fan. It's going to splatter all over the goddamn wall. Just get that in your mind.
Oh my God, we gonna get drunk.
Get your girl on camera.
We gonna get
look at that.
Drunk.
Are those tattoos?
No, I think it's leggings.
I don't know, bro.
She looks like an alien, a reptilian.
This camera ain't high quality or something.
Yeah, that camera, I don't know what's up with the zoom on that. The one you got, does that zoom good?
Better than that.
That zoom is shitty. It takes too long to become clear. They ain't even worried about these bitches. They laugh at us and we didn't even pay attention to them.
Oh, she was talking to that Chinese girl. They called her a pussy.
Oh, okay. I was about to say.
Hey, was talking to that fish-eyed chink.
Fish-eyed chink? The zipper heads? You didn't find that? Went up to the something heaven. Just do a word search on heaven.
Search on heaven and a thousand scriptures coming.
And that's what I was about to say.
Let me see, I'll find it. Where do you look at it? I'll look for it. Just bring us something else at while I look for it.
That's what I did a search on.
I bet people watching YouTube, like, you motherfucking dumbass.
Here, you can do it.
And they don't know no scriptures.
Posted the scripture. I hope so, though.
Yeah, you should be in that spirit, actually. Like, yeah, that's I can't believe y'all don't know that.
That's right. You know what? I'm trying to find it, bro.
Hey, bring something else out, Deshaun.
Like, occurrences at the same time. Shh.
Read Isaiah 6. What did you better read?
Oh, I had a scripture, bro.
Go ahead, bring it up. It really is. Heaven occurs a lot. But I know.
We're talking about the missile shaking and stuff.
What's the name of this app?
That's Cadre.
Oh, Cadre. I never used it.
Yeah, it's my favorite.
My favorite one's the one I made, but my phone died. See, don't nothing work better than my Bible program.
Here we go.
First
this is Corinthians Isaiah
12 and 21.
Isaiah 24 and 18.
Oh, I'm just guessing.
Isaiah 24 and 18. And it shall come to pass that
it's in Corinthians.
He who fleeth from the noise of the fear shall fall into the pit. And he that cometh up out of the midst of the pit shall be taken in a snare. For the windows from on high are opened, and the foundations of the earth do shake.
The windows. Read that part
now,
again.
And we're talking about the Lord's nuclear missiles, if you're interested. Okay, I'm going to read it again. And he that cometh up out of the midst of the pit shall be taken.
Oh, yeah, it is 2 Corinthians 12 and 2.
2 Corinthians 12 and 2.
See, that's what I said. 2 Corinthians 12 and 2.
Did you really say that?
You did say that.
No, I said 1 Corinthians 12.
That's bugged out. Here. He actually guessed the number right. 12. That's bugged out. You're bugged out, Paul.
2 Corinthians 12, right?
No, look, my boss was weighing out soup today. I was like, I'm going to make a guess on how much it is. It's 42 pounds. It was exactly 42
pounds. Rain Man. That's intuition, though. We all got that. Like, there's a lot of truth in that intuition. What's that something they call? You can get real close in your mind. You might be kind of off, but you'll still be real close. What's that called? Intuition. What's that shit the military that hired the psychics, but they call it remote viewing?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
That there's right. truth to all that shit, man.
Oh, yeah, of course it is.
You know?
Of course it is, yeah.
Look, there goes Bruce Lee's cousin.
Y'all some bugged out mobikes, man. Bug the fuck out. Oh, see, I looked up unlawful, and it says not lawful. And it says not lawful.
Doesn't say that?
Yeah.
I've never seen a chink wear skinny jeans lawful. Before.
Well, you've seen it now.
I gotta go in my Bible just so I can remember where it is.
Okay. 2 Corinthians 12:1.
Hey, you see we found it though, right?
Yeah, we did find it.
That's right.
It took
that's
long
right.
enough, didn't it?
Yeah, I don't give a damn. You know, we found it.
It's been a minute since I've read this one.
Mm-hmm.
You know, actually this whole week I've been studying nothing but Abraham. That's been my thing all week.
2 Corinthians, I'm gonna start at the top. 12:1. It is not expedient for me. Doubtless to glory, I will come to visions and revelations of the Lord. I knew a man in the anointed above 14 years old. Shalaka. I knew a man in the anointed above 14 years ago, whether in the body, I cannot tell. Or whether out of the body, I cannot tell.
He said, he's like, that sounds like some astral projection type stuff. You know what I mean?
That's right.
Could that, hey. You gotta be a spiritual person to even believe it.
That's right. I cannot tell. The Most High knows.
The Most High knows.
Such a one caught up to the third heaven.
To the third heaven. That's what it was, the third heaven. So that must be in the spiritual realm.
And I knew such a man, whether in the body or out of the body, I cannot tell. The Most High knows. How that he was caught up into paradise and heard unspeakable words.
Unspeakable words.
Which it is not lawful for a man to utter.
Yeah, you can't. Yes, that's just.
That's
it right there, man.
You know?
That's powerful, though.
Yeah. Or such a one will I glory, yet of myself I would not glory, but in my infirmities. Infirmities. For though I would desire to glory, I shall not be a fool. For I will say the truth, but now I forbear, lest any man should think of me above that which he seeth me to be, or that he heareth of me.
Yeah, you know, he don't want people to worship him or nothing like that.
ISIS.
And lest I should be exalted above measure through the abundance of the revelations, there was given to me a thorn in the flesh, the messenger of Satan to buffet me, lest I should be exalted above measure.
Look at that word messenger in the Greek, and it says agalos, which means angel of Satan.
Mm.
You know what I mean? This is not a little... I looked that up before in the Greek.
Mm-hmm.
Go ahead.
For this thing I besought the Lord thrice, that it might depart from me. And he said unto me, my grace is sufficient for thee, for my strength is made perfect in weakness.
You know how... You know how in Revelation, this is kind of going off topic a little bit, but you know how in Revelation 12, it says that there's a war in heaven and the angels fought against Satan and Satan's angels, and people think that's talking about fallen angels. They're like, no, the angel, they think that's some kind of spiritual being. That's not what it's talking about. That's a messenger of Satan. Or of Esau is what it's talking about, messenger of Esau. And man, it's the same thing as that word right there. The same word in Revelation as agalos is the same word used in that scripture for messenger right there. Go look it up.
Most gladly, therefore, will I rather glory in my infirmities that the power of the anointed may rest upon me. That was it.
That's a good scripture. He called your boy ISIS. He got mad. He was looking at you funny when he was walking away. Well, ISIS, that goes back to the Queen of Heaven of Egyptian mythology. Now, what you wonder why are they Muslims when they call themselves ISIS? Or everybody else call them ISIS? Or some people call them ISIL or IS.
ISIL.
There's a reason they keep calling them ISIS, though, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Well, in the Quran, there is something in the Quran called the Satanic Verses. Get on the internet and search Quran Satanic Verses. And you'll find out that there were Satanic Verses in the original Quran that gave praise to like four different female deities. You know, which goes back to this Queen of Heaven and Isis and all that shit. They was like the Ishmael version of Isis. So pretty much all that fucking Quran shit comes out of paganism. That's why they worship a goddamn meteorite. You know what I'm saying? A rock fell from the sky and they thought that was holy.
That's why we call them rock stars.
Oh, rock stars. Good one. Yeah, and over there they had that, what's that, the hajib they shit they have every year at Mecca. This past year at Mecca, it just happened not too long ago. It was like hundreds of people died, they got trampled to death. Because everybody was so eager to go touch that meteorite inside that cube. They had trample over your ass just so they can touch the rock.
Right.
And every year hundreds of people get trampled to death. That's worse than a heavy metal concert in the mosh pit. You know what I'm saying? That's only something a heathen would do, man. That's how we know they're heathens. You know, I mean, it don't take a rocket scientist to figure that one out. To figure out what is a heathen and what is not a heathen. If you can't figure out what a heathen is, you got a problem. Do y'all know what heathens are? They ain't got a clue.
They are heathens.
Actually, anybody who's not in the truth is a heathen. Whether they're actual physical heathen or not, they're spiritual heathens. You know? Engaged in heathenry. That's all these fools out here, they ain't engaged in nothing but heathenry.
Heathenism.
Hey, you can't take this shit, man.
Some call them heathenites.
Heathenites.
Proud of these fools.
But some of them are proud to be heathens.
That's right.
Call them uncircumcised heathens.
You know, possum from the root.
Because really, the word heathen, that actually goes back, it means one who dwells in the country. But that's not what we're saying. A heathen's a goddamn heathen.
Motherfucking Muslim.
Yeah, fucking Edomite, an Ishmaelite, a Hamite. Anything that's not an Israelite is a heathen.
Goddamn Muslims.
Or a Goyim as...
Goddamn heathens. Goddamn heathens, man. It's vexing to your soul just to be around
them. I'm going
to
get his heathen scripture. He said, yeah. You know what I'm talking about. Yeah. I'm going to get it. Jeremiah 10 and 1. Hear ye the word of the Lord. Excuse me. Let me read this again. I can't see. Jeremiah 10 and 1. Hear ye the word which the Lord speaketh unto you, O house of Israel. Thus saith the Lord, learn not the way of the heathen, and be not dismayed at the signs of heaven, for the heathen are dismayed at them. So, right, like we said, all of our people are engaged in heathenry, right? Form of heathen. Christmas is the top form of heathenry on the planet. Because Christmas is all based around astrology.
Sucking Osiris's penis.
That's why back in the old days they called it Saturnalia. That's dealing with the signs of heaven. You know, dealing with the fucking Capricorn and the Zodiac and Saturn, all this heathen shit. And dealing with the solar. Because, you know, December 24th is the longest, the shortest day of the year. Meaning, December 24th.
Heathens.
What's up, heathens?
Hey, Esau, our twin brother.
He fucked me up, man. December 24th. Is the shortest day of the year, meaning the day where there's the least amount of sunlight. The sun is in the sky for the least amount of time on December 24th, all right? This is a fact. On December 25th, that's when the days start getting longer again. And, you know, and so people say, oh, the sun has risen. And That's where you get Christmas. It's a celebration of the days getting longer and the sun coming back again, so you don't
sun
fucking
worship.
Yeah, sun worship, pretty much. And that's being dismayed at the signs of heaven. You know what I mean? That's all it is. But you tell people that, I'm like, this is Jesus' birthday. No, you're fucking stupid, man.
They're like, they done lost the meaning of Christmas. We're like,
yeah, that's why we got to put Jesus back in Christmas. You see that shit? Everybody's up in arms over Starbucks, now putting Frosty the Snowman on coffee cups. So,
oh my goodness.
They said that's anti-Jesus. I mean, you scratch your head like, these motherfuckers are stupid.
Show me where.
Well, first of all, Starbucks, this symbol, they got like some mermaid, some ancient fucking fish deity on their goddamn cups. A mermaid. Go back to worshiping Dagon. The planet Sirius. I mean, the star Sirius on their cups.
There's some more instructions on these heathens, man.
Fuck these heathens. Hold on, let me read the rest of this real quick. I'm sorry.
Okay, go ahead.
Because we just mentioned Christmas. So this goes right into the Christmas tree.
Yep.
Jeremiah 10:1. Hear ye the word which the Lord speaketh unto you, O house of Israel. Thus saith the Lord, learn not the way of the heathen, and be not dismayed at the signs of heaven, for the heathen are dismayed at them.
Yeah, because some motherfuckers will drop to their knees. Oh,
yeah.
Oh, you know.
And that's why they put a star on the Christmas tree. Go back to the stars again. For the customs of the people are vain, for one cutteth a tree out of the forest, the work of the hands of the workman with the axe. They deck it with silver and with gold. They fasten it with nails and hammers that it move not. That's talking about a Christmas tree. Only a heathen puts trees in their house. And then they deck it with silver and gold. That's where you get that old Bing Crosby song, silver and gold, silver and gold. You know that shit.
Never heard it before in my life.
I'm dreaming of a white Christmas.
they're going to edit that out and make a mixtape with you singing it.
Right.
But now they say white Christmas is racist because it's a white Christmas. This place is nuts, man.
Oh, they say that Charlie Brown is racist too because he ain't got no black woman, man.
Oh, see?
That's some crazy, stupid shit these
people. It's getting bugged out out here.
It's going too far over there.
It's
going too far.
But they don't ever fuck with us. We can say whatever we want. I go with that scripture.
That's some wild shit, man. This is Deuteronomy 18:9. When thou art come into the land which the Lord thy power giveth thee.
Oh, sorry.
Thou shalt not learn to do after the abominations of those nations.
Abominations. Christmas is an abomination. Look, that's because the Christmas tree is actually what we call a grove or an asherah pole. It actually represents a lot of things. Well, represents the Queen of Heaven. They back in the ancient world, they worshipped Asherah / what was her Babylonian name? Semiramis. They worshipped her, and her symbol was a tree. Or also it was a bunny rabbit, just like on Easter. That's why, do Easter bunnies lay eggs? I mean, do rabbits lay eggs? Back in the ancient world, one of the symbols of Semiramis was the tree, which was another symbol was the rabbit, which represents fertility because she's the goddess of sex. But they would take, back in the ancient Babylon or Samaria, they built these giant pyramids called ziggurats, and they'd have the priest of the devil, the Baal or whatever, on top of it. They'd sacrifice children, and then they would take eggs and dip the eggs in the children's blood. That's where you get coloring Easter eggs from. Mm-hmm. There's more heathen shit.
More heathen shit.
Go ahead with that. Read that again.
When thou art come into the land which the Lord thy power giveth thee, thou shalt not learn to do after the abominations of the nations. There shall not be found among you anyone that maketh his son or his daughter to pass through the fire, or that uses divination, or any observer of time.
Observer of times. Christmas,
yep.
Saturnalia, Easter.
Or an enchanter, or a witch.
And really, a diviner of times, that's going into astrology. People, they always trying to get an astrological reading, you know what I mean? You know, they get on Yahoo every day or whatever website they use, and they checking out the astrology. And that's on the front page of Yahoo's the Zodiac shit.
It's a popular shit.
It's right there. And then what a bitch, the main thing a bitch asks you when you first meet a bitch, she be like, what's your sign?
Oh, what's my sign, bitch?
She'll give you the rundown after you tell her.
Yeah, you be like, oh, I'm not compatible with you, honey. You know what I mean? Because they would be serious. If you're not compatible with them signs, she ain't fucking with you. Trust me. My fault, go ahead.
Or a charmer, or a consorter with familiar spirits.
Familiar spirits, that's it. They be playing with the Ouija boards. Oh, you see that, there was a big story in the news a couple weeks back how this bitch, she there's a Ouija board app on her phone, and she said she was playing with the Ouija board app. She got possessed by devils. Wow. And they got a video of it also. It's viral on the internet. It went viral.
Wow.
And it shows they had a pulling a Catholic priest or something to try to get the devil out of her. And you know that didn't work. That put more devils in her.
Call her Bob Larson.
Yeah, Bob Larson. Yeah, y'all got to get on YouTube. Just search Bob Larson exorcism. But first, you got to get you a drink and just sit down.
Some popcorn.
The popcorn. You have a good laugh.
I got to remember that.
That'd
or a charmer, or a consorter with familiar spirits, or a wizard, or a necromancer. For all that do these things are an abomination unto the Lord, and because these abominations, the Lord, thy power, doth drive them out from before thee.
Yeah. You ain't supposed, right. Here it is, the Lord commanded us to destroy these goddamn heathens. To just the fucking to pulverize them to pieces.
I told that to someone to work today. They was like, Paul, God would not say that. That's the devil in you speaking.
Oh, really? They must have never read this.
I was like, no, the Lord would agree with me.
Well, yeah, let's see if the Lord is in agreement with you. Deuteronomy 12:1. These are the statutes and judgments which ye shall observe to do in the land which the Lord thy God of thy fathers giveth thee to possess it all the days that ye live upon the earth. I mean, every day. Ye shall utterly destroy all the places where the nations which ye shall possess serve their gods upon the high mountains and upon the hills and under every green tree. And ye shall overthrow their altars and break their pillars and burn their groves with fire, and ye shall hew down the graven images of their gods and destroy the names of them out of that place. So this says, because you know Christmas trees are grove, right? The Bible actually says you're supposed to take a Christmas tree and burn it with fire.
That's right.
But I'm not telling people to actually do that because you might get locked up. We live in Satan's kingdom.
You could tell that was a black bitch sorority walking by us. They wouldn't shut their fucking mouth.
Right.
All loud and shit.
They all part of the same thing, too. Whatever Greek shit they part
of. Man, we supposed, yeah, according.
They eat each other's pussy, you know.
According to the laws of the Bible, you supposed, yeah, to all them sororities and fraternities. If we was living back in the ancient world, they'd all got burnt with fire. We all burnt every, with them in it, we will burn it to the ground.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying? That's scripture. I just read it.
You take the witches and burn them in the
fire. You take the witches, you burn the ass with fire. And then you bring the whole town out. Everybody would praise the Lord. We would sing a hymn. You know what I'm saying?
That's right.
Yep. Even King James used to burn. That wasn't, what, 400 years ago? That was in more recent times. King James was still burning witches in the fire. Why? Because he's a man of the Lord. He believed in a righteous judgment that you're supposed to burn a goddamn devil worshiper. You burn the ass.
Those are Caligula's people.
Huh?
Those were Caligula's people.
Caligula's people. Hey, this is Caligula's kingdom. He's back in a reincarnation. We don't know who he is, but hey, we might have an idea.
Try narrow it down.
Try to narrow that one down, boy. God damn.
Oh, hell yeah. Hell yeah.
What is that? Is that a St. Bernard?
Yeah.
What is that?
Beethoven.
That's a big ass dog.
You better go let it lick his balls.
No, I will.
That's what you know.
Bring it out.
225. Withhold that foot from being unsure. That's not short. And that throat from thirst. But thou says there is no hope, for I have loved strangers, and after them will I go.
Yeah, these fools, they follow after strangers, meaning the heathens. They'd rather follow after every tradition except for their own traditions. Because this is our tradition, is right here.
This, righteous tradition. That's beneficial.
But what do our people do?
You know, go way.
But because, first of all, they spoon fed.
Who's got that?
By the so-called Jew, they spoon-fed all this bullshit on TV and through the music and TV and all these movies. They're taught to follow the ways of the heathen. So that's why yoga is so popular. Hindu is so popular. That's why every other person will tell you, I'm a Buddhist, but I still love Jesus. You know, they're into every tradition and philosophy except for this right here.
You can't even split a pope.
There goes some more sorority hoes.
Yeah. Oh, that's bad luck.
Superstitious bullshit. Yeah.
Don't step on a crack, you break your mama's back.
Yeah. They believe that shit too.
Yeah, but yeah, man, these people, they gone, man. They will, and they're very accepting of any so-called religious belief, except for this. They'll accept, you name it, if you're a devil worshiper. Hey, man, that's some cool tattoos, man. I like that pentagram with the upside-down cross. That's fucking fly.
Oh, that's a sweet Baphomet tattoo.
Oh, that's fucking badass.
Yeah, yeah.
But if you
cool
say...
spot is on your forehead, too.
Right, but if you say that you believe in a Bible, or if you quote a scripture, they'd be like, man, I don't want to talk about that.
Shit gets quiet.
Wow, you got 666 tattooed on your back.
Yeah, you gotta have 666 tattooed right on your goddamn forehead, and everybody will accept you. But don't quote no scriptures, though, because then all of a sudden you're causing problems. I might have to ask you to leave.
There's one thing we don't talk about around here.
Religion and politics. Oh, but yeah, you mean the Bible and politics, huh? Because you can talk about Buddha and Hindu and all this other faggot shit, and they'll have no problem with that.
They teach you every single fucking Egyptian guy, every single Greek
right.
guy. They talk about so-called Jesus for 5 minutes.
You one mention of the Lord, you gotta go. You gotta stop. You're making me feel uncomfortable. Well, motherfuckers, you should be uncomfortable. I was at this spot, fucking with some heathens. There's some heathens. I ain't gonna say who it was. There's some goddamn heathens. But the same thing happened. We was talking about UFOs and shit, and shit was cool. You know, but then I said the Lord was coming back in the UFO to burn motherfuckers with fire. I gotta go. I don't want to talk about this.
What's that?
Like, I'm just trying to give you some truth. You was interested in UFOs, but now you're not so interested.
These motherfuckers are eyeballing us.
Woo-wee.
Feminist as a motherfucker.
It's just like this story of Abraham, when the Most High came down to Abraham. He's like, if you can find one righteous man up in Sodom and Gomorrah, I'll save it.
What did it start with?
Well, it started with 1,000 or what?
He was going through the city.
Because Abraham was like, you ain't got to destroy that. He's like, I'm going to destroy it.
Through the city too.
Yeah, he went up there. There was one righteous dude in there, and he got him up out of there. It was Lot. But his was wicked ass wife.
It was funny because he was trying to burn his stepson's in law, and they was looking at him like he was a joke or something.
Yeah.
He said he was mocking him or something.
You seen the video for the new JNCO's commercial?
Was there some demonic devil?
No, shit? They got a gay dude wearing some skinny jeans, and guys over in there like, hey, bro, your pants are like super tight.
But JNCO's, they're like bell bottoms, ain't they?
32 inch bottoms.
The fuck, I ain't wearing that shit. Bell bottoms was not. If you wore bell bottoms back when I was growing up, they might have got beat up. I remember I had some bell bottoms once. I put rubber bands on them. You know, when you pour, you just get what you can get, right? the only pants I had. Shit, I remember I was in the seventh grade. I had two pairs of pants the whole school year. I had them on rotation. I thought I could do the right rotation up and figure out that it was the same. You be feeling salty, man. That shit was rough, bro. And don't go to school with no funky ass shoes on either. Or if somebody find out you got your shoes from Schottensteins, they're like, oh, you got them from Schottensteins. You don't remember them days?
I used to do.
Man, that time got you like, you buy a shirt and one of the fucking sleeves be
amazing.
Ooh-wee.
I'm snatching that one up with the quickness.
There goes your homie.
Good boy, he got about, probably got about 10 pair of jeans in.
He getting ready. He's sleeping out here.
Yeah, he's getting ready. I just watched a movie last night on some homeless motherfuckers. They live good, man.
They may really.
I think they living bad, but
hey, shit, I was thinking about if you go, you could go to LA, live on the beach, because they got showers at the beach, and still have a job. Go to a laundromat, clean your clothes.
I dream about that sometimes, giving up all my possessions and just saying, mm-hmm. fuck it, go live like a bird. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean?
Go to your homie.
I would love to do that, man.
Here you go. This is Route 6 and 5. Beware, therefore, that ye in no wise be like to strangers, neither be ye afraid of them when ye see the multitude before them and behind them worshiping them.
Oh, yeah, I ain't afraid of no goddamn heathens. Like, when I see Muslims walking down the street with their heathen shit and Somalis and all this other foul shit, or if I see fucking Jews walking down the street, every time I see it, I drive through Bexley. If I see a crowd of them, I'd be, yo, Esau, you're going into slavery. You know what I'm saying? If I see it,
Esau.
Yo, Esau.
Hey, Esau.
And they look, too, because they hear that Esau. They, huh? Because they know about Esau.
Hell yeah. Especially the higher up.
Yeah, they know
the
what time
ones,
it is.
The older ones.
Yeah, they know what's going on. Mm-hmm. We even had that Jew out here that one day years ago.
She giving the dog care that she drives.
Right, she's jacking it off.
They had a, during that one, that young Edomite.
Which one,
and
down there?
And he told us,
right
and, yeah, down
with
there.
With no shoes right. on?
Yeah,
he didn't have no shoes
that was
on.
Him. Right.
And he said, in the temple, they taught him that the Jews were actually
Edomites.
He's
like, yeah, some time ago I heard that.
He did. He's like, they taught me in the temple, yeah. Mm-hmm.
They know who they are.
And they ain't no fucking secret.
Yeah.
It's in their own, we've read it 1,000 times.
That dude looked like he was bugged out on PCP.
Yeah, but like people with Muslims, like you, if you see Muslims and shit, you're supposed to say shit to these people, man. You're supposed to like make them let them know that they're a heathen and remind them like you're a fucking heathen. I don't like you around me with your
man,
heathen
I
shit.
I smell a heathen right now.
Yeah, it's,
it smells like dirty piss or something.
You got people, they just so afraid to speak out against anything, man.
Dude, let's go longboarding, dude.
Oh, yeah. That'd be a good place to live.
Right there in the Jeep.
That's shit. A nice Jeep.
Esau do that shit, though. Esau do it because he can.
Yeah, it's an adventure.
Yeah. Do that shit because he can.
What that one train hopper dude we met that one year?
Yeah.
He was living a good life.
He had a CSX tattoo.
Yeah, CSX tattoo. That's hard fucking core train hopper for your ass.
All the way from West Coast.
Yeah, he said he traveled the whole country by hopping trains. Been everywhere. He like Johnny Cash. I've been everywhere. Yeah,
that probably would be some fun shit.
And he came up with a big ass sandwich. He's like, man, I just got this out the trash.
Yeah, that's what I do.
And he's living, he's eating better than me. Picking the trash picking. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. It's amazing. What's up, Esau? You know who Esau is?
You.
Hey, your show's coming on, The Walking Dead.
Oh, Walking Dead is on tonight.
He looked like The Walking Dead.
You think watch that when I get home, shit.
ZTV?
Yeah, Easy TV.
You eyeballing
they
us,
gonna
boy.
They going
to
shut it down.
Esau?
Hey, Esau. How's it going?
How y'all eat a mic's going?
Y'all ready for destruction?
Esau is a big fucking faggot.
I never installed
He loves to suck uncircumcised penises.
A straight up piece of shit.
Esau is uncircumcised.
What's up, Edomite?
It can't be circumcised. It's not possible. Only Israel is circumcised. That's a metaphor. Even most of our people are uncircumcised spiritually.
Hey, what's going on, bud?
Hey, what's up, duder?
What are you guys trying to show here?
Oh, nothing, man. What's going on?
We're prophesying about the end of your bullshit-ass society.
You see that right there? See that slavery? That's coming to a so-called white man.
Are you guys, like, trying to get people to join the Church of Satan or something?
You're in the Church of Satan, dude.
I'm in the Church of Satan.
You are Satan. You're the devil.
I am Satan.
Look at you. You got horns coming out your head.
Yeah.
A big fucking devil.
Probably loves sucking cock.
Human flesh between his teeth.
Good luck with your recruitment process.
All right, devil. Got him.
Remember the one that was used to come out and talk to us all the time?
Oh, the German dude.
He wouldn't be his friend.
Yeah,
really
the German
hurt,
dude.
He was really hurt.
He was mad, yeah. He was really interested.
He really was wanting to cry. He was going to cry, man. We ain't seen him in a while.
He said he's from Switzerland.
Mm-hmm. He used to travel there.
Oh, he used to travel. Yeah, something like that.
He used to travel there all the time.
He looked like Swiss German. Big dude. Yeah, I actually, that's funny you said that because I was going through my stacks of DVDs and I seen that one. I was about to watch it.
The last day we seen him, remember he was about to start playing?
He was living good. Yeah, he was mad because he couldn't understand why we hated the world so much.
And him.
And him, yeah.
Who, the kid that said he was a video editor?
Yeah, that was him.
Yeah, that's right. He did some shit too.
Yeah. And he said he was very extremely wealthy.
He lived in Bexley.
Did he? Yeah. You gotta have money to live in Bexley. That's where most of the Jews live. I drive through that raggedy motherfucker almost every day, man.
You know, I seen
right
a Jew
it.
Up in Bexley one day. Someone hit his car, and the Jew got out the car. He looked at his car, and there wasn't no scratch or nothing on it. He said, "Oh, you're good. Go ahead." I was like, "Whoa, are you fucking kidding me?" Surprised the Jew didn't try to take everything he had.
Even among them Jews, we're not going to throw them. Look, man. Just like
it was at Lev's pawn shop. He was there picking up money.
I'm going to tell you this. Our people are scattered among all nations anyway. Okay? We already know that. Just
is that a guy?
Everybody who claims to be a Jew or a Muslim, they're not all fucked in the head. And you know what I'm saying? A lot of them treat people with kindness. You know what I'm saying?
I thought that might have been Caitlin's little brother.
I think those were trainings.
Right, yeah. They were twin trainings.
But I was saying, hey, let's get the parable of the Good Samaritan. Get the Good Samaritan, Luke 11. Is that Luke 11? Where's you about to go?
Go ahead.
Yeah, man, I'm going to bring that out, man. Because, you know, like some people, you know I fucking hate Muslims, but I know every last person who claims to be a Muslim. They're not no goddamn extremist, terrorist, jihadi, you know what I'm saying?
Yes, they are.
They said, yes, they are. No, they're not. Well, we're going to read the parable of the Good Samaritan. We'll find out.
Luke 10.
No, is it Luke 10 or 11?
10.
Yeah, there you go. I was close.
Luke 10:25. And behold, a certain Lord stood up and tempted him there and saying, Master, what shall I do to inherit eternal life? He said unto him, what is written in the law? How readest thou? That's pretty much it.
Yeah.
And he answered, said, thou shalt love thy Lord. Let me get you a point.
I just go ahead and read that. I like that.
And he answered and said, thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, with all thy soul, with all thy strength, with all thy mind, and thy neighbor as thyself.
Right, because you got a lot of people out in the world. They might have been raised up as a Muslim. They didn't know no better. That's the way they was raised, but they still fear the Lord, you know what I'm saying? And then they try to treat people with kindness. You know what I'm saying? They want to help people. Because not everybody is all the way fucked in the head. Our people are scattered everywhere.
You got 10 and what?
27.
Because we could be over in the Middle East and something happened to us, and a Muslim might come out and save you. You know what I mean? But then that's when you come in, you give them the truth. Starts, you know what I'm saying? Go ahead.
And he said unto him, thou hast answered right, do this and thou shalt live. But he, willing to justify himself, said unto Yahushua, who is my neighbor?
Who is my neighbor? Keep going.
Yahushai said, a certain man went down from Jerusalem to Jericho and fell among thieves, which stripped him of his remnant and wounded him and departed, leaving him half dead. And by chance there came down a certain priest that way, and when he saw him, he passed by on the other side. And likewise a Levite, when he was at the place, came and looked on him and passed by on the other side.
Right, because here there's an Israelite guy all messed up, robbed and shit, left for dead. And one of his own people came by, who's also an Israelite from the tribe of Levi, just left his ass in the damn ditch. You know what I'm saying? But they were supposed to be brothers. How come he didn't help him? Keep going.
Look, all of them are dressed exactly the same.
Oh, yeah, they sure are. But you'll have a lot of people who claim to call themselves Israelites today. They'll act like that too, man. They'll leave your ass for dead. I ain't worried about it. Fuck them hoes, man. Let's get this parable out.
Yeah, fuck them hoes.
By chance there came down a certain, but a certain Samaritan, as he journeyed, came where he was, and when he saw him, he had compassion on him, and went to him and bound up his wounds, pouring in oil and wine, and set him on his own beast, and brought him to an inn, and took care of him. And on the morrow, when he departed, he took out two pence, and gave them to the host, and said unto him, take care of him, and whatsoever thou spendest more, when I come again, I will repay thee. Which now of these three thinkest thou was neighbor unto him that fell among the thieves? And he said, he that showed mercy on him. Then Yahushua said unto him, go and do thou likewise.
Right, so what's the moral of that story? Is, like I said, the Israelite didn't even save his own Israelite brother. But a heathen, so-called heathen, came through, saved his ass, took care of him, you know what I'm saying, and saved his life. But we know that Samaritan was actually an Israelite that was scattered among the heathens, you know what I'm saying? So you're going to have that. You're going to have people who are people who are scattered among these heathens, and that they fear the Most High, they love their neighbors, you know what I'm saying? They treat people with respect, with kindness. And you're supposed to, that's the people you're supposed to be praying that the Lord wakes up, man. And they're fucking all over the place. They can come in all colors, shapes, and sizes. Well, I don't know about all sizes. 500-pound pork grizzle eating motherfucker.
Calvin got him a job. You see Calvin walking by?
Calvin? No, I didn't see Calvin. Hey, get up. What you about to get? Yeah, that's why you got to be spiritual. Because you got a lot of people who call themselves a Jew. Jews are the devil. But the Esau's, them goddamn rabbis, you never know, man. Some of our people could be scattered among them. I mean, that's part of the curses.
That's the
shit that they're going to do. That's what they get, though, for not following the... That's what Israel gets for not following the commandments. That's an extreme form of punishment. Matthew 13. Yeah. It's a long one, but you can get to the point quick in a... Yeah.
Matthew 13 and 18. Hear ye therefore the parable of the sower.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. When anyone hears the word of the kingdom...
That's it. The whole chapter is wheat and tares.
But it's 24.
Oh, you're in 24?
No, I was reading up here.
Okay, yeah, but what the whole, it's a long chapter, but yeah.
This is Matthew 13 and 24.
Oh, you're good.
I'm gonna skip to 36, this is long as hell. Then Yahushua sent the multitude away and went into the house. And the disciples came unto him, saying, declare unto us the parable of the tares of the field. He answered and said unto them, he that soweth the good seed is the Son of Man. The field is the world, the good seed are the children of the kingdom, but the tares are the children of the wicked one.
Yeah,
the
children of the devil. Cause yeah, right. Anybody who just called himself an Israelite, that doesn't mean they're righteous and holy, you know what I'm saying? Cause you got a lot of people who just base everything just on skin color, and they accept anybody the same color as them. Or they'll say, what some dudes that that had that Passover or something, they said that African wasn't allowed to come to their Passover because he was an African. Who was that? I seen GMS talking about it. But they was hating on this dude because he said he was from Africa, but he was obviously a Jake.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
But they, because people ain't spiritual, man. They'll judge you just by where you're from or what you look like. This is dumbass shit. You're supposed to judge someone by their fruits and by their spirit. Go ahead.
And then the enemy that sowed them is the devil. The harvest is the end of the world, and the reapers are the angels.
Yeah, the angels are like the grim reaper. That's the Lord and the angels. People always act like the angel of death. That's the Lord, is that the angel of death. He come on with that sickle. Remember that one song, Don't Fear the Reaper? They give you all this gruesome imagery. Hey, that's the Lord. He coming back on that rider on that black horse. Y'all go ahead.
As therefore the tares are gathered and burned in the fire, so shall it be in the end of the world. The Son of Man shall send forth his angels, and they shall gather out of his kingdom all things that offend, and them which do iniquity, and shall cast them into a furnace of fire. There shall be wailing and gnashing of teeth. Then shall the righteous shine forth as the sun in the kingdom of their Father. Who have ears to hear, let them hear. And I skipped the whole parable.
All right, you should have started from the beginning.
You might as well read the whole chapter.
That whole chapter,
it is a good chapter.
It just put everything in perspective from the beginning to the end to that part, man.
Yeah, because you skipped the part where it said, let the tares grow up with the wheat.
That's right. And the wicked, like, I forgot which group where I see shit, whatever.
Yeah, you get tired.
I think they're the motherfuckers that's pushing that. Let them grow together. That means they allow Edomites to come in and be a part of their camp.
That was GOCC.
I can't remember which one.
It's
being pushed now.
Like I believe it, man.
Yeah, it's being pushed real heavy right now. And they're using that scripture that let them grow together. How are you going to grow together spiritually with some heathens that's non-believers, man?
Because you could tell a heathen by the spirit.
Just by the spirit, yeah.
I mean, I know a heathen when I see a heathen. I know that motherfucker's a heathen.
I know that I got this Hamai's phone number in my phone. I want to clown him so bad, call him on camera.
Nah, don't mess with me.
Should it be hilarious? Right.
So you only start at 24 since...
Yeah, go ahead, read it, man.
Okay.
That's a bad chapter, man.
Yeah, I love that chapter.
That's actually one of my favorite chapters in the whole book.
Yeah.
That's
one of those things that's hard to be understood by most people.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5 parables, not one chapter.
Yeah, that's bad.
Yeah, it's pretty. That's why I said it's pretty long and in depth.
That's what we out here for, is to read this.
Read it.
Read these scriptures anyway. It's edifying for the videos, people. You know.
Yeah.
Matthew 13:24. Then the parable put he forth unto them, saying, Kingdom of heaven is likened unto a man which sowed good seed in his field. But when man slept, his enemy came and sowed tares among the wheat, and went his way. But when the blade was sprung up and brought forth fruit, then appeared the tares also. So the servants of the householder came and said unto him, Sir, didst not thou sow good seed in thy field? From whence then have it tares?
But you know that's a parable. If any of y'all ever had a garden, had grown a garden before, I gotta deal with this every damn year. I plant carrots, and when your carrots start growing, it looks like fucking grass. But I got grass growing in my garden too. So like, what's growing? Is that grass or a carrot? You don't know. You gotta wait for them to grow up. And then when it gets bigger, then you know, oh, that's the carrot, that's the grass. You know?
Yeah, Esau lays pesticides that's specific for certain grass.
Oh, he's a devil.
Or weed or whatever, you know.
And then that pesticide gets the food and you eat it and you get cancer and drop dead. What's that shit they call Roundup? Oh, that's for the bugs.
Yeah. Monsanto's control.
Yeah. That's for the bugs. Yeah, but I know what you're saying. They got certain that stuff that just designed just to kill weeds.
Yeah, specific stuff, yeah.
That doesn't even make sense.
That's crazy, yeah.
That is not safe. I don't want none of that shit nowhere near none of my plants.
Yeah, and we got to eat that shit, man.
Nowhere. I don't even want it near my regular flowers, let alone plants. My edible food, you know what I mean? That can't be good for the regular flowers either. All right, well, go ahead with it.
What he said? He said unto him, an enemy have done this. The servant said unto him, wilt thou then that we go and gather them up? But he said, nay, these while ye gather up the tares, ye root up also the wheat with them. Let both grow together unto the harvest. And in the time of harvest, I will say to the reapers, gather ye together, first the tares, and bind them in bundles to burn them faggots. But gather the wheat into my burn.
That's what he said. When you a bundle of sticks is a faggot. And literally, that's what the word literally means.
Faggots are in the Bible.
Yeah, you ever read the book Lord of the Rings, he used a faggot to light his pipe. It actually says faggot. He pulled out a faggot.
Didn't he say fag?
No, it's faggot. It's a faggot.
This is another movie that says fag.
What is faggot? The word still survives today. In England, they call cigarettes fags. Mm-hmm. Like, let me get a fag.
Yeah.
And that's why we call faggots flamers.
A flaming faggot.
Yeah, see? I mean, that's...
There's a Western that I was watching that said fag, though.
Yeah, I believe it. Yep. I would go, is that the point? That was the point where he read right there, yeah. So that proves that Israel scattered and heathens, or where everything's been mixed together. That's what they call America the great melting pot. Because everything's just mixed together. You don't know who's who.
Bowl of gumbo shit.
Yeah, gumbo.
Tune
up,
buddy.
Can tell by the spirit. Each person gives off a spiritual vibration. Each person has like a spiritual aura, like a spiritual field, like that surrounds a person. You know what I mean? Like an aura. I can't explain it. You either get it or you don't get it.
Yeah, you watch Dragon Ball Z, the Saiyans got a power that they can sense who's evil.
Yeah.
From distances, they can feel it.
Yep.
You know?
They can. That's all based on some Israelite shit.
That's all it is, man.
Yeah.
No, ain't nobody Jake's over here.
You know, I know all about Dragon. My sons love fucking Dragon Ball. That's all he fucking talks about. Like, Dad, who's your favorite character? Like I told you, it's Vegeta. Vegeta goes hard.
Vegeta's my favorite.
It's like I told you 1,000 damn times, Vegeta. He asks me every day. He loves that shit. He studied that like that scripture or something.
Dragon Z, bad as fuck.
Yeah, it's some good shit.
Here we go. This is Matthew 25:30. And cast ye the unprofitable.